No Notes.
We're here this evening again with the fabulous and mighty, mighty Intruders. And we happen to be speaking to
Curtis,
a.k.a. Luther Vandross. So tell us, how did you get into, when did you first recognize that you had that capability?
Actually, it took a while. I basically grew up liking Leaving After Whispers.
Oh, okay.
Pretty much mimicked the Whispers as much as I could. And then once I got a little older, once I graduated from high school and kept doing it, I realized that Mr. Vandross came along and I'm like, hey, to me, he just pointed to my...
He changed the game.
My favorite thing, my favorite vocalist. And I love a lot of them, but he's my favorite, I have to say. That's my favorite.
I didn't really start mimicking him.
I guess I was like about, believe it or not, like 25, 26 years old before I started even trying to imitate him in a lot of ways. Love his style because the voice is always real smooth and pretty, you know. And that's why I just like the Whispers so much, because Scott and Walter had that smooth prettiness too.
Because
I thought that nobody could sing a love song like the Whispers until I heard Luther Vandross. He would take a song that may be somebody else's, but make it his.
But see, the Whispers to me was more like a sort of, like you say, they can sing a love song, but they had a little risque twist to it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Central.
And then they could do a little scat. They had a little scat.
They had a jazz version. You know, but they seemed to sort of touch the girls. Yeah. The females tend to get all.
All those songs they did. All those Chocolate Girl. All those favorites. Those classics to me. I don't know how big they went worldwide, but they were all classics to me.
True.
But then Mr. Vandross, man.
Let me ask you one more question. The woo woo. That Luther's woo-woo, you hit that. When did you first realize you could do that?
I didn't realize I could do that.
It's something you just impromptu did on stage.
It just happened one time on stage.
Okay, cool.
I started off doing Dance With My Father.
Okay.
Right, okay.
That was the first one. And then House Is Not Home.
Okay.
But House Is Not Home was about my favorite, but I actually wound up singing Dance With My Father first, okay, in front of an audience.
Okay.
Then House Is Not Home started, and I started practicing that, and kind of perfected it a little bit.
So I started putting it
in the act.
Okay.
You know, okay. Especially when I saw the crowd kind of enjoyed it. Mm-hmm. And I guess after he passed, you know, the Lord rest his soul, you know, I want to, in my own way, keep his legacy
tribute
going.
Right,
like a tribute to him. Yeah. I want to honor him as much as I can.
And you've done that too. You hear comments about your being able to imitate him and so forth. And as he was beloved and everything, that certainly keep that thought alive.
Yeah.
So what do you think your success? I know that the Intruders are surprised, and like most of the groups here, were 40 years, and you're still out here singing your music and everything. Did you think that your music would be a success 40, 45 years?
No, I didn't. No. Not like it is now.
True. Right.
Not to this point.
And what do you think contributes to the success of this type of music?
I think a lot of it, I contribute a lot of it to, when I think of this type of songs that we do, and I call it old school, because that's what it is. We're old school.
Okay.
I'm not a proud to say it. I'm not ashamed to say it.
Okay.
We're old school.
Yeah.
But see, with old school, you can tell it like it is. Mm-hmm. You can sing a love song, because, I mean, you can talk about everyday life. And that's what these songs do. You hear stuff like, love is like a baseball game, three strikes you out.
Exactly.
That's real simple.
That's true.
But yet, it's something that we experience in life, every one of us. And everybody can relate to it. Another thing about our songs, even the little kids can sing. Our songs are clean.
Exactly.
When we get married, you know what I mean? the little ones, from the little to the smallest to the oldest, can sing the Intruder song and relate to them. Cowboys to girls, who don't like that? Shoot them up, bang, bang.
They're catchy. They're catchy, and like you say, they add to life itself. Is something that people experience every day and everything. So, and something like that will always, because it's what we call something that's classical. Something classical will always live and everything. And so you guys are a classical group. And as a group, we think that...
I'm proud to be a part of it.
Right.
And that's represent well.
That's why we enjoy interviewing you, and we wish you success. We hope that in some ways that we will contribute to your success by letting others know about your success.
Please do.
Always glad to have you with us.
Same here. Thank you.
No notes. We won't take much time, but no notes again. Welcome you back. We have followed you again. We've seen how successful this group is, and we want to certainly welcome you back. And this is
Dean.
And Dean, how long you've been with the group?
6 years.
6 years, right. And are you enjoying the success of being part of the Intruders?
I am loving it. You know, the experience with you guys, we have fun, you know, and we have serious things.
Right.
And, but the thing is, we all come collectively and we get the job done.
Right.
Yeah, so I enjoy myself.
Okay, yeah. All right. And as I just brought out with Curtis, being a classical group because of the things you sing is classical. That means that you can go on and on and on as long as, you know, your strength and health will let you do that.
Yes.
And that's a good thing.
But the music that we are doing will live forever.
That's so
live
true.
Forever.
That's true.
Again,
that's
true. Like Curtis said, it's clean.
Right.
As it's easy to pick up. There's no harsh lyric to the song.
Right.
And it's life lived music.
Right.
You experience something, you know, matter of fact, I had the pleasure of meeting Kenny Gamble and Leon Huff in 79. And I met them, and I was with I don't know if you heard of 3 Degrees.
Yes.
Helen Scott, the 3 Degrees, she introduced me to Kenny Gallagher, Leon Huff. You know, it was a promotional party going on. And the question was asked, what makes the music so great to him?
Right.
And he was saying, because of it's clean, it's true. It's something that he experienced in life. And he bring that to life. He paint a picture so you all can see and understand and feel that music.
Right, yeah. But as I brought out that Kenny and I went to Bach together and everything, and at lunchtime they would have a duel, and Kenny had a group, and he used to sing to endeavor to hit the night up. He used to sing with Bunny Single. Bunny Single went to school with me too as well, and everything. And so, like I said, when I look and see what he has done with the ones that he's promoted and everything, certainly, and I hear about the Philly sound, although I'm in New York, I've been in New York for many years, I'm always proud to know that I've come from Philly and I can understand the Philly sound. It's very distinct, and you guys are a part of that.
They are a major influence. I think it's noted group stars and OJs.
That's my favorite.
Oh, really?
That's my favorite. Right.
Well, you guys helped put Kenny Gamble and that's correct. A strong influence on Philly soul.
Yeah, like I said, individually, we have a talent. We have quality. We have, you know, and when we come together collectively and blend those harmonies, you can reflect back in time when Kenny Gamble first started off with the Intruders, because we bring that sound,
and that's
those harmonies.
And that's what's so amazing how you guys today can bring that across. It sounds just like it did back in the day when it first came off the press.
So Dean,
yes, we're going to make a short, like you promised, and everything. And certainly, again, we've enjoyed interviewing you, and we will continue to follow you guys.
I got one question I want to ask.
Right.
Now, you had one intruder said his name is his AKA, that's pretty cool. What's your AKA?
AKA Hurricane. I'm coming, wiping up today.
And that note, people call it a rap. Okay, this is Hurricane.
Okay. We're glad to be able to get back to the Intruders. We're with the the No Notes were with the Intruders some time back, and we just had real success with their interview. And you guys seem like you've been just keeping the ball rolling and everything, and we're glad to see that. We have here
John.
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 This is John.
But John, you've been with the Intruders how long?
Oh, 6 years.
6 years? 6 years. I'm going back with, I went to school with Kenny Gamble.
Oh my gracious.
Right, and
he won't date yourself.
No, yeah, we were at Bach together, and so when he came out of school and everything, I see him, and when I would hear about him, because I moved to New York,
okay,
and to see the work that he brought together, you guys come together, and how the Intruders, other groups did well, but you guys have really put yourself on the map.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Now, you see, you've been with them
six years. Well, we are with the extension. We have been a part of the Intruder family. Who since then passed on.
Right.
And the other two, which is Phil Terry and Big Sunday, both of mine, semi-retired right now.
Right.
And we're all a part of the same family. Right. So they are our bosses.
Okay. All right. Well, certainly you guys have made a name for yourself. Now, Watson here, go ahead.
I just want to say, so you want us to trade, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, from time to time. Yeah.
You sang one of the songs tonight.
Yeah.
You did a pretty good job, I must say.
Well, you know, I was fortunate enough to meet him back in the early 90s, and he used to call me a shadow.
Okay.
Well, I only do one. Okay. My other partner does the other one.
Okay. Let me ask you a question. In your songwriting,
yeah.
How do you determine your lyrics? What song you going to write about? Let's say, for instance, like when we get married. What would motivate you to write a song like that? Not necessarily you.
Well, I guess what motivates Kenny is true to life experience. That's
okay.
With every songwriter.
True.
And I happen to be a songwriter as well. You know, it's true to life experience. It's things you deal with. I wouldn't care if he was at Thanksgiving and sit down and somebody ain't give you no cranberry sauce.
You can write a song about it. That's amazing.
That's basically what songwriting is all about.
So to piggyback on that, bring up to date. Have you guys entertained thoughts of possibly writing something contemporary?
Well, right now we're Sony has taken over a lot of things, and we're going to be stretching out a little bit. So whatever they have in store for us, we'll have for you.
Okay. I'll be looking forward to it.
Okay, we're looking forward to doing
and
it
the
for
same
you.
Quality.
Oh, yeah.
Same quality. I want you to
gotta keep the same quality. Okay. You know, Kenny set a standard, man.
Right. Yeah.
Him and Leon, it's set a standard.
Okay.
So we'll we're glad to be here with you.
Glad to be here with you.
The No Notes will be visiting you again as we follow you guys' career continually.
Okay.
And we certainly thank you.
Okay, and had a ball being here with me. He had a good picture of us. Remember, I'm the pretty one.
All right. Yeah. Okay, here we are once again, No Notes Show. We're catching the Intruders here as these guys have just finished up a very fine show here at the TD Bank Arts Center. And we have Captain Fly. And he is one of the ones that have been very instrumental in keeping and anchoring the Intruders as they continue to have their success. And we're glad to have you with us.
It's an honor. Coming up to a show with George Benson, 10-time Grammy winner. and you know the audience. Just a wonderful thing. This demographic is rare because it's called popular music. It was popular, meaning that everybody likes it. So in touring around, I've had the distinct blessing of working with a lot of different artists. Peebo, James Ingram, Dionne Warwick, Worldwide. And the key, the audience is first and foremost. So these kind of artists, that, pretty much all of the artists, they want to make a statement and make you feel something. If you're in China or in Japan, and they don't speak English. But they know the words of the cowboys and girls. You know, so that's extremely endearing, and that tells you pretty much how the music travels. So one night a guy will say, man, no, that's the songs when I was in Vietnam.
I'm going to call them on the phone.
And it has melodic. Look at the music. Tom Bell. The first four people at Gambling Hub were Tom Bell, Phil Terry, who was original member of the Intruders, Kenny and Leo. So you imagine that chemistry with Tom on the keys and knowing the strings and the perfect pitch.
That's mind-boggling.
Just unbelievable. Yeah. So now you got music that could only be on for 2 minutes, 3 minutes at best. So a record anything over 2 minutes, 38 seconds was long.
Yeah.
You had to have all the lyrics, all the discipline, all the music and the heart inside that song. Now, at the same time the Intruders were out, you got the Temptations way before the OJs, Shep and the Limelights, the Motown Sound, Memphis.
Right.
All of those sounds were a different chemistry, but they all came from one root. So based on the fact that all of us have put gray in our hair and mustache for the camera, because
right,
we're dark hair, so we just, I feel better that you guys did that. And then I know for sure.
Sure.
Yeah. So you look back and you think about the songs and the times. I'll say 8-track, I'll say 45, you say 45 records, not a gun. I'll say drive in, and the kids say drive by. So imagine these kind of songs, and the guy said, well, man, I've lived through Vietnam with this, I did that. 1961, it was Come Home Soon, when, that's y'all song. Now, when Kenny and Leon went to Columbia, to create the legacy known as Philly International, after South Street and all of those songs and how much the music was rich, all of a sudden they said, well, what do you have? They said, well, we got this and a collection. So the groundwork, the Philly International brand, what came live, not on the backs of the Intruders, but they were integral part. So the presentation was the package that the Intruders had come looking to promise. Now look. Now you got a guy like Prince that can come up and do everything for the technology and the artistry. Imagine Donny Hathaway having the same toys that Prince had. So now you look back at Tom Bell playing on the piano down in the basement. And now it's a legacy. And this kind of music, based on the demographic, you can look and say, somebody 55 to 80. I can say two or three words. And I say Beatnik and Sputnik. It's not even a dictionary.
But it can be related to that.
It can be related.
Generation. Right. Exactly.
The honor for me is the audience.
Right.
The delivery and the presentation of an original piece.
Right.
You go to a wedding, you expect them to say, I now pronounce you man and wife. You don't remember that part. You remember When We Get Married, the song.
Yes. Right.
So they all tie in together. On Mother's Day, I've always loved my mama.
Right.
It's a reunion. Families argue back and forth. So what happens with Gambling Huff? Family reunion, OJ.
Yes.
So see, you're tying some things together, and then when you take that root, just like Dizzy Gillespie, Count Basie, and Arnie Carver, and the rest of them, you look, you say, well, tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to change the whole chemistry and move you over to here. I move you over here, and I take somebody like Tom Bell and put him with the Spinners. Or Tom Bell with the Delphonics.
That's awesome.
You see where I'm going? So it's a small mission for us to keep the legacy alive. What our mission is to maintain the credibility.
Bottom line.
Exactly.
You know, you can do a lot of things and you can sound like a lot of people, but the texture of the presentation. Now, some groups, they'll say, well, sing all of the Intruder songs. Well, we can't sing our favorite song because I like Baby I'm So Lonely and Gonna Be Stronger. Number 14, number 17 on the chart. So we have to take into consideration all this and do the top 10 songs. But now, the top 10 songs were okay, but how much imagination would we need for me to give you vanilla ice cream and put something else on top of it? So now we give you the Intruders legacy, but the gift that Curtis has was entertaining your family with Luther in conjunction with the ice cream. My man, Dean, doing the OJs or Wildflower in conjunction with. So we say, why would I sing a song that I like and not a song you know? So come to the show and let us entertain you respectfully.
Well, again, that keeps it classic, and then you keep it classical. You're going and keep it moral. Man, you're going to it will continue. It's eternal.
I got one for you for spiritual or mental. What's EGO?
Ego.
What does that mean? That means that somebody has another position, they might kind of be something. Now, you know what it really means? EGO means edging God out.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Because at the point of connection, you are no longer a member of the audience. You are now better than them, and you want to prove it by singing, as opposed to giving them a blessing. Be careful, I got another one. You don't want another one.
So basically, you'll lose your audience.
Well, you don't lose them if they can't find you because of your ego. You're up too high.
You're edging God out.
You're edging God out.
That's profound.
You got another one? That's profound. Ready for another one? Be careful.
Said,
no.
Okay, go ahead.
Illuminating on that door is a what? A star. A star's up in the sky, and the sun hits it, and it lights up. And you say, like, when you worship on a star. But the stars are reflection of it. So if you spell star backwards, the word is rats. Imagine a rat on stage who took your money and doesn't want to sign the autograph.
That's profound.
You scammed me now. This guy scammed me. You better stop. I had one more, but I don't.
All right.
No, you can't stop now. You on a roll. You got my underwear.
Go ahead. Give us one more. Give us one more.
You want one more?
Right. Okay. My suit jacket, I just wanted me to grab my suit.
Come on.
Okay.
Let's it's all right.
The commercial break.
Go ahead.
Good. And let me.
All right.
Thank you.
There you go. All right.
Big okay.
That's it.
So, we got one more.
Imitation is the best form of flattery, but imitation is nothing when it comes to money. Imitation money is counterfeit.
True that.
Imitation groups are counterfeit.
True that.
So, you really don't get what the market entails. You're getting what the facsimile is as opposed to the respectful presentation of the product. This has been going since 61. Gambling Huffer kept a legacy. Biggest problem we had, I came aboard in 95. Al Goodman, bless his soul. I'm a DJ, radio, two radio shows. So I had the opportunity to MC. But I get the advantage on the other MC because now you don't have to hire an opening act. Because I sing.
Right.
So I bring a track and I'm your crash dummy. I'll fill in the blanks. Al Goodman says, man, you sound like Sonny Brown. Sonny's deceased. I'm going to tell Bird about you. Bird comes to D.C. Fantastic Bird. Sonny Bird, old Sonny in the song. Yeah. I give him all my information. He's in ailing health and declining health.
Mm-hmm.
He passes on. 3 years later, I run into the guy that went through his package. So through the whole gamut of the Intruders reviewing those things, we kind of hone the skills to present the product. I can do concrete work. But now, can I finish?
Okay.
So now, at this point, the audience is the finisher. The audience is utmost and the most important. So when we come in and put a unit together with the blessings of Phil Terry, who has the original brand, it's difficult to say, man, y'all are imposters. But because of business, I can't let somebody say, you got this and it's not that. So it took us about 18 months to actually clear the catalog of people who were pursuing it illegally.
Oh, okay.
Now, it's on our job to go from the, no disrespect, I love the Elks, I love Knights of Columbus, I love all those facilities because they're regional and local. But when you come to a TD Bike Center, you better bring the real guns. So if you have the opportunity to be blessed enough to excel or to raise to that level because of the George Duke, that's where you want to stay. So now doing George Duke, maybe a Gladys Knight, this
George
one that
Benson.
Was stopped.
George Benson.
George Duke's deceased. I don't want to do him.
George Benson.
I'm sorry. Right. I travel with all of these guys. I said, man, wait a minute. So when you do that, you've automatically accepted the burden that you want to respond to the audience at this level.
Right. Okay.
So costume changes are necessary.
Right. Yeah.
The variety of music, the importance of the original key being presented is important to us because it's subtle and important to the audience. You can do anything with your money, gas, electric, phone, cable. You take time to come to a show in trouble times like these, it's an honor.
Well, I know we hear a great response from people when they say, when they hear the Intruders, they say they want to come. So obviously they feel they're getting a genuine thing.
And they're
getting more bang for their buck.
Who likes the whispers?
And everything.
Who likes the whispers?
I do.
Who doesn't
I
like do. The whispers?
Okay. All of the girls love the whispers, the guys love the whispers. Who were the twins' idol, and who did they open for and idolize and follow around? The Intruders. So, the song that they did, that Al Johnson, one of the legends in the industry, did, was I Want to Know Your Name, in a total tribute. And the other song they did, just to show you how important singing to singer, is We Miss You, Donnie, which is Donnie Hathaway.
Yes.
Now you take that emotion, you wrap that up, you dress it up, you show up on time, you do a great show,
right,
and you come to hear Cowboys the Girls, but before you did, like, you had to be Lutherized. Before you heard Mama, you had to be Eddie Lavertized.
Okay.
And never forget that we're humble and respectful. That's the best part of this.
Very humane, too.
Okay.
Very humane.
Thank you very much.
You all right?
My
brother.
Right. See you at the next show.
That's right. We'll be there.
Wish you were here.
The Intruders and No Notes.
The new group, the three. We'll tell you later when you sign the contract.
Oh, camera man.